Hello guys, and welcome to Format Tutorials. And today, and this is the part 2, how to make a 2D platformer game in Unity. So today we're going to deal with the movements, and in the previous part we just set up this simple scene. Okay, so in order to move, we need to add a script to our character. So before, as we go, this is a 2D platformer game, so I'm going to hit for 2D constraint and freeze the rotation on Z axis. Then I'm going to add the component and create a new script movement and create an add. Let's open up in the Visual Studio. Okay, it's now open up in Visual Studio. So here there are two default functions, start and update. To start, basically going to execute before the update, and basically the first frame, and update going to execute every frame. So before, let's create first a variable up here that's going to control how fast and slow going to be created. So I'm going to type public load, and I'm going to name it speed. This will be the speed of the player. In update function, let's take some input from the user. So input dot get access, and just give access name, and this is going to be a horizontal. Make sure H with capital, else is not going to work. Then access this function could see this matter going to return some values. So this one, so when you press D on the keyboard, is going to return 1, and if you press E, is going to return -1. So we need to store in somewhere. So I'm going to create a vector 2 and name it move direction simply. Then here move direction dot x, we're going to store this value in x axis because we need to move the player on the x coordinate. And so if I show you okay, now if I go to move the position on x, it's going to move the player on the x, so we need to move the player on the x axis. So I'll see here. And if I then I'm going to the white fix the bit to create a new function here. Now basically when we for movement, when we want to move up physics stuffs, we use fix update, and we use update for non physics stuff and taking inputs. So let's here we need to move for parts, so we could actually need a reference for our rigid body. So I'm going to type public rigid body 2D. We have a 2D scene, so we need a rigid body for 2D scene. Rigid body 2D, and just name it in RB in short form. Then on here, I've typed RB.velocity, so we're going to change the velocity depending on the what key is pressing. So just type move direction and then multiply by this by speed, then multiply this by time dot fixed delta time. We have a fixed update, so we need fixed delta time. And if I go to back to this editor and just make the speed to 10 and drag and drop the rigid body, and this will go to work. So it's working, but it's too slow. Let me increase that speed more. Yes, now working perfectly. We are moving the character in the correct direction. So first thing, I did not want it to have a huge value for the speed, so simply I just remove the speed and create a two brackets here. Then here down here I multiply the speed multiply by 10, so this mean 10f step load. So this mean like it's a scene 10, so actually the overall result of the speed is going to be 100. So I just only have to type 10 and the value become 100. Look, it's the same speed as 100. I'm going to give by 15. Okay, so I think 20 is going to be a great value. Yes, you. Now our movement part is done, and let's go for jump part. So in order to jump, we need to fix one thing. Like if I drag this player up, it's going to come very slowly down, and actually gravity working. So if you think increasing the gravity scales, this make the movement much heavier. Look, I have the 5 and can't move this player. It's slow. but still not going to fix it. So increasing the gravity is not going to do anything, and increasing the mass is also not going to work. I mean, the mass does not depend on the gravity, so it's not going to work. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to force the player to on the ground. For this, I'm going to create some more variables. So first, I'm just clean it up. And down here, I'm going to create some variables here. First, I'm going to create a vector 2, a mobile mode 2, velocity. And up here, I'm going to create a public float gravity. This is the value of the gravity. Gravity is equal to 9.81 F. This is going to default value. Then down here, we just are going to do here. We make velocity dot y is plus equal to gravity. So we increase the velocity every frame, and then multiply the time dot delta time, and also we need to apply this in velocity. So I'm going to create one more vector too. Player movement, and this one the actual player movement, I think, and down here is going to call it. Then player movement is equal to new vector 2, and then first I'm going to give the move direction dot x multiply by some the same value, control plus c, control plus v, and just keep comma here and give velocity dot y, and I will close this and remove this move direction from here, and simply I type view movement and then multiply time to delta time. So it's work. So now player going to be always on the ground. Here is all settings. So if I'm going to drag the up, it's going to be minus 9.1. I forget this, it's going to be minus 9.1. Okay, so if I'm going to drag the player up, it's going to come down. And I can, so it's working. Let me fix it here to make minus, and also I'm going to multiply this velocity by 10, so it's try to make force on the ground. I just want to force much as I can, and let's play again, and then I will drag up, so it's come down really fast, and that's what I needed. Okay, the problem is that velocity, if you look here, if you info, and I want, first I go to this debug mode. I want to show you one thing, like its velocity on the y increasing every frame, like it's increasing. We need to stop this value increasing. So if I all the time increase, it happens something like this. So yeah, we need to stop this. So I'm going to create a ground check. So we need to specify check is the player on the ground, so we stop the velocity to increase, and then we're going to force the player. So I'm going to create a bool variable. Bool is grounded, and also public transform, and this is going to be a ground check. Let's make this ground transform ground check. So right click here, create empty, and I need this. Okay, ground check, and then simply just drag this ground check on the legs of this object. Somewhat here about 0.2 radius, and then it's check if the layer, if there is a layer ground going to touch with this come in the circle. So it makes sure this become true, this counter become true. So next I will type is grounded, sorry, need condition, sorry, if is grounded and velocity, I need to check velocity is less than or equal to 0f, then you make velocity, sorry, we need to check velocity dot by, velocity dot by, velocity dot y is going to be equal to somewhat minus 2f, and I did force the player onto the ground, and this is going to work. Okay, so let's go to the character and just assign the ground check to him, and then I'm going to the tiles, select the all the tiles, go to the layer, add a layer, type ground, then again I need to select all of them, and then select this ground layer, and the what is ground, so we'll just assign the what is ground. Now if I play check the debug.log, and if you check the velocity, it's just around something minus 2, and if I going to go up, it's going to come down, really working perfectly, and our gravity is working now. Now let's add the jump. So adding jump is pretty easy, and we need to create some variables first here. So public float name it jump height, then down here, so we need check, we need to get a condition like if input dot get, but we need to check the if a player pressed some buttons like space bar, then we need to jump. So we need create a jump. Now jump is a predefined function that horizontal is to the predefined axis, and jump is also the predefined button in Unity. If you go to the edit to the wheel settings, and here like major axis, and you find horizontal, vertical and jump also. So it's jump, and also we need to jump, have one more condition, we need to jump when we are on the ground. So the type is grounded is equal to true, okay. And then we need to jump, so we need to jump, we just need to increase the velocity of fine, and there are some mathematical functions revolving around the jump. So it's like math of square, we need to square root the jump height multiply by minus 2, then multiply by gravity. So this is the math of this is a math function of a jump height, some equations. So if I go into the ground, inspect back to the normal view, and I'm going to give some jump height, for example the 6, and if I play, and after 6 pieces bar, I'm okay, going to jump, and it's all not jumping in the air, but jump after the when we reach the ground. So I think of increasing the gravity some more time, like 4, so 39.2, and I would also get a jump height by 10. Just look, now player is jumping, and so jump player look jumping very good, so a player can jump. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to decrease the circle more smaller, one, increase this by, so multiply this value by 4 by 5 is okay, 49, increase the jump height by 15, and it's going to work, and speed by 20. So it's customize the value according to your needs. So it's very difficult to find the correct value depending on the game, so but I think this value is really good. So let's set it by 20 and make it 10, and now everything is working. Now let's make the character flip in the direction we are moving. Now let's add the flipping and flip. So it's pretty easy to do. So what to flip the character? We need to, instead of we can't rotate the player, but it's not going to work. If you can rotate the player too, and next thing you can do is just change the scale of the character. Like look, if I change -1, it's going to look this side, and if I'm going to scale 1 this side. So actually, value depend on you, depends on you. So what kind of value? So first I'm going down here, just down here. I need to check if move direction dot x is greater than 0f. So this means that if the direction is 1, like if you press D key, we are moving on the right side. We are moving on the right side, so we make transform dot local scale. Make this local scale and give a equal to new vector 2, and we're going to give here -1 = 1. So make sure your position going to be correct, -1, and then create one more condition, same as it, move direction dot x is less than 0. This means we are moving on the left side. This means value of when press A is -1, and we are moving on the left side. So we type transform dot local scale, or local position I type. Wait, I also write here local position. We need to change this by local scale. So local scale. Local scale equal to the new vector 2, and here we're going to give 1 by 1, and this is going to be work if I'm going to play the game and just press is going to see that side of we are facing. So value actually depend on your what character. Basically generally this right side have the scale 1, but with this character has -1. But we need to test out what value satisfies, and make sure your value that they have 1 y axis, so also they have 1 and 1. Okay, so player movement part is going to be done, and in our next video we look on the animation and the camera. And so that's it for this video, and if you like this tutorial, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next part.